Une nouvelle thérapie pour le cancer permet à certains patients de vivre plus longtemps. Mais au Nouveau-Brunswick, nous devons quitter la province pour l'obtenir. Ces patients endurent un traitement rigoureux, au loin de tout ce qui leur tient à cœur. Cette année, nous venons vous demander votre aide pour acheter de l'équipement qu'il faut pour offrir cette thérapie de pointe au Nouveau-Brunswick. Grâce à nous tous, ils pourront rentrer à la maison.
Chris Atkinson is like a lot of cancer patients. He fought it off once, but when his cancer returned, it didn't respond well to standard treatment. Just like bacteria can develop a resistance to antibiotics, cancer cells can develop a resistance to chemotherapy. The only way to kill those cells is to overwhelm them with much stronger doses of chemotherapy. But there is a downside to that intervention. It's very hard on the patient, and it destroys their bone marrow and immune system. Bone marrow is vital. It is a factory that produces white blood cells that fight infection, platelets that help your blood clot, and red blood cells that circulate oxygen throughout your body. These components are vital for survival. So what do we do? There is a technique that allows us to deliver extreme doses of chemotherapy while preserving the tools to restart the marrow factory. It used to be done using a procedure called a bone marrow transplant, a painful and invasive procedure, but today, patients have the power to save their own lives. Stem cells circulate in the blood in very small numbers, so we have to give the patient a mixture of drugs which will cause the adult bone marrow stem cells to move out into the bloodstream. Once the cells are circulating in the blood, we then collect them using a specialized piece of equipment called an apheresis machine. Once the cells are collected, we then count them, preserve them, and freeze them using other specialized equipment. Then we perform the extreme chemotherapy. Once the high-dose chemotherapy has cleared from the body, we are then able to perform the transplant. The transplant is similar to a transfusion. We take the stem cells and thaw them and reintroduce them into the body, where they will travel back to the bone marrow and grow into new blood cells. The next big milestone for our patient is engraftment. This is where the patient's stem cells begin to grow within their bone marrow and manufacture new blood cells. The equipment used to deliver this exciting treatment is a platform that will allow us to build a whole new category of disease treatment procedures. This will enable us to attract and retain the finest medical minds and allow our hospital to provide leading-edge procedures right here at home. I'm Dr. Terence Como, and I'm the Director of Stem Cell Transplantation at the St. John Regional Hospital. I'm a New Brunswicker, and I came home 2 years ago to do this work. This is a new tool in the fight against cancer. We now have to rely on labs in other jurisdictions to offer this therapy. It's difficult to watch patients undergo this therapy without their loved ones and other support. This extreme chemotherapy brings them to the verge of death, and the reintroduction of their bone marrow stem cells is a rebirth. It's demanding, but it's also effective. I've seen the results. Life expectancy is longer. Curing cancer is possible. Chris Atkinson is one of those success stories. He's just had a clean body scan, and that makes Chris, his family, and those around him feel pretty good. Because after all, cancer doesn't just affect the person living with it, it has an impact on their whole community.
That's why this year, the St. John Regional Hospital Foundation is asking the community to pull together and give, so the hospital can purchase this important equipment, enabling it to offer the innovative cancer care that will give us all hope. Together, I know we can do this.